And even Christ is probably not your salvation because you're not doing what Christ said. If you want Christ to be your salvation, you got to do what Christ said. Or at least try. Christ used words like strive, seek, persevere. He didn't just say think something and then you're automatically saved. Because that is nonsense. Matter of fact, he said, those who say, Lord, Lord, but don't do the will, they are not my brothers and my sisters. And he warned about the many who would say they believe, but he actually calls them workers of iniquity. Christ's plan was simple. Only a few things did he command us to do, and one of them was to sit down in the tens, hundreds, and thousands. And if you look at the history of the early church, not the Constantinian church, but the early church, that's what they were doing. They were organizing in the tens, hundreds, and thousands. That's just a matter of historical record. The remnant of that was still in existence during the American Revolution. We had tithings, tens, hundreds, and thousands. Now, that's just been expunged from the average guy's history. But, you know, we quote lots of historians at the website and in some of the books have been discovering that that is the most common form of self-government throughout the history of mankind, is that people organize themselves in ranks of tens, hundreds, and thousands. 10 men, 10 families get together. They pick a connecting point, a minister to connect them with everybody else, a national connection point. And then he gathers with 9 other guys like himself, and they pick a connection point, a minister to minister that connection point. Because this is how you create a national and international network. And then you add the teachings of Christ, which is not covet your neighbor's goods, judge not lest you be judged, don't take a bite out of your neighbor, forgive. All these basic principles of Christ in that network. And now you will have a viable republic in the heart of the Roman Empire, in the heart of the Nazi Empire, the Third Reich, in the heart of the oppression of Rome. You would have this viable republic. That's what it was called. And Gibbons, he referred to the Christians as a viable republic in the heart of the Roman Empire, an ever-increasing state. But it was a state where the individual had the right to choose how much you were going to give to a particular cause.